What is just going right now, in your opinion, just from a rhythm standpoint, a play calling standpoint, whatever you want to call it, that's clicking with this offense?
I think we've done a much better job just going through the week of just building momentum and confidence and getting like things practiced. And sometimes now we're getting some looks we don't anticipate. Matter of fact, we actually sometimes feel like we spend a lot of time practicing against certain things, and all of a sudden you get defended differently, whether it be the way they're kicking their front or the blitzes you're getting. And that's always a part of it. There's a little bit of jockeying early in the game. I think we've done much better. I felt early in the year when we struggled, we didn't come into the game with momentum. And I think we've came through each week with some momentum. Now you still got to execute on Saturdays, but I think we're coming into the game with some confidence and some momentum during the week of practice.
And you sitting there with Ryan Day next to you, have y'all found you can adjust things quicker? I mean, as it's gone, have y'all developed a chemistry in that respect, or whatever you want to call it?
Yeah, and I think we're getting some great communication, I think, you know, from Coach Meyer during the week of things he wants to see or why. And I think, you know, Ryan's doing a great job of making up some past thoughts. And, you know, I got a little idea of, like, tempo and going fast. And I think just, you know, we've kind of figured out short term. Now, again, you know, there's always going to be bumps in the road. You don't block it well, or you don't guess right and call a bad play, you can get behind chains. But right now, we don't have all the answers, but we're working together very well. It's fun.
$64,000 question now is, though, y'all haven't played against Murderer's Row when it comes to defenses, you know, the last five games. As Urban Meyer says, he's realistic about that. But how do you see this carrying over into this starting next week against a really good defense in Penn State and what you got to face down the road?
I think a big part of that is kind of what you do this week. You know, sometimes when you're playing well, you want to keep the momentum. We've talked about during practice, and we're not trying to over-practice, and we're trying to get some guys some rest, but we're also really working with the older guys, keep bringing our offensive line along, the tight end group along, our depth and skill positions. So to me, there's a way you practice, you know, during this week that kind of keeps the momentum, because you're going to lose game day Saturday.
Yeah.
And you see some teams play well, and all of a sudden they falter. That next thing, you can over-practice, you can under-practice. Right now, we have a lot of positive energy, and we're just trying to keep that through this week. We've had two really good practices the last 2 days. It's very encouraging. Our defense is very, very competitive. Even though we're going to play against some tremendous defenses starting this week at Penn State, we get that every day in practice, and we go so much good on good. To me, that kind of sharpens us the way you need to be sharpened.
Kevin, there was a talk about how much you might want to use the tight end in the passing game. It seemed like that showed up last weekend and maybe for the last couple weeks. Is that to the level where you want it or envision, or how would you evaluate their impact on the passing game for you?
I would say, actually, I think earlier we've tried very, very hard to force some things to come to them, but by the structure of coverages and rotations or protections, and they didn't show up in the. I would have told you a couple 3 weeks, okay, this is going to happen, we're going to get this guy the ball here, and here, and it didn't happen. And really, Saturday, we didn't really think about it happening, and it did. So sometimes it's just the flow of the game, and you know, it's kind of like the good Lord, when you get greedy and push things, it doesn't happen. And so I think right now there's nice balance, and as they come on, JT's comfortable. You can throw the ball outside. You got good players at the slot. Running backs are coming along. Keep the tight ends. There's a lot of skill. And I'm used to when the offenses are good, you're not forcing it to one guy. You're spreading the ball around, because when the defense takes away a space, they give you a space, they give you a matchup, and you want to be able to take advantage of it.
Do you have to tell, like, Marcus or Rashad, because you said that a couple weeks ago you thought that might be a big game for them, that's just the way it works sometimes at a position?
Very, very much. In fact, I even told them before that. I said, every time I've tried, I've told guys, like, hey, we're going to do this, it never happened. And so, you know, at the end of the day, I just appreciate the way, I think, you've heard, if you go back and listen, I've listened to JT on a couple things. He talked about the way we're practicing.
Yeah.
And the thing encourages me, even though Marcus or Rashad didn't get balls, they kept their practicing better. And there's good momentum with our football team and with good practice habits.
And where does Rashad, I don't know if rank or whatever, can you put in context, like, his athleticism at the tight end position compared to some other guys you've had in the past? It seems like a very naturally explosive guy.
Extremely explosive. As explosive as just innately physically skilled as any kid I've dealt with. So he has a high end. He's learning how to play the position. So much of it's done in the off season. So in fairness to him, he loses all of spring. We didn't move him to the very end of summer. And so he's had a short window to polish his skills. He has a high ceiling, and I'm encouraged by the way he's coming along, and he's playing well, and he's not even close to so many things he could do better. He's got a chance to be a special player.
I guess he was gonna like
I'm very proud of him too now, because it would be coming over and it didn't go well early. Right. You know, that first game in Indiana, don't get a lot of plays. He's battled through some things. I'm very proud of him. He's done a great job for us.
How much still, even a lot of as good as he's right looked now the last few weeks, is he still just getting by kind of on that natural athleticism, but not necessarily good night being a fully formed, fully rounded tight end?
Yeah, he gets by a lot with his athleticism. Because again, as fast as we play and techniques, fundamentals, and being able to process and fairness to him, he's swimming upstream. But I appreciate the way he approaches practice. He's working hard. He has a high ceiling. He's not close. That's not a putting down. I'm proud of him. He's doing well. He could be a very, very fine football player.
What are the options that having him and Marcus both have proven they can go down the field and catch the ball, and pretty decent routes and things like that? What does that give y'all down the road, if you understand what I mean, Kevin?
Yeah.
From ability to attack teams.
You know, he does, but you know, same time, both those guys got to keep coming on the blocking game. Because the reason you want those two tight ends in there, you can block down, you can down around, you can reach block, you can lead for the quarterback. And so, to me, the more they keep learning, and that's where Rashad could be so much better. As an athlete in space, great basketball player, very natural. Just learning how to be a great blocker. And so many plays, we don't play without the ball. It's where Marcus is coming on. And the more they keep coming without the ball, the more they're going to play for us.
Like on J.K. Dobbins' touchdown run start game, I thought Rashad got a pretty good block on
very much.
I mean, does that in some ways encourage a guy that he can do it?
Very much in visuals, and that we try a lot in our teaching. Coach Meyer's very unique in his approach to us of finding those visuals and selling that to your kids and keep bringing them along. So those are, he's also had some plays we didn't like,
yeah.
but as, again, the more he plays, the more comfortable, confident. Because even though he makes that one touchdown or a couple catches, looks good, there's so many plays without the ball. And for Tim, for you to notice, that was a pretty nice block, this run, JK.
Yeah.
There's more plays like that than touchdown catches. And the more he keeps coming on there, the better we're going to be.
How's your confidence last question different for in the Kevin unit now than in the first two weeks?
Excuse me?
How's your confidence in your unit differ from now?
Unit meaning tight ends?
No, the offense as a whole.
I think we're getting where collectively we're better than we are individually. We put it all together, the way those groups can play. And so that's what we're trying to sell right now. The more we play together, the more we play for each other, the more guys play, linemen stepping up, those second, third tight ends, those second, third running backs, those 5, 6, 7 receivers, the more guys play, the more energy is. It just, it grows that chemistry. And right now we're building it. We're going in this day and age of everybody's ego and give me the ball, Mike Weber having a really good game, two guys pushing 100 yards, the more that keeps happening, the better we're going to be.
Great. Coach, thank you.
Thank you.